Just the boxing now here with Eddie Hearn. Eddie, first of all, how are you doing? You're a busy man always, yeah. But it's always good to see
you. Yeah, I mean, last week I actually had a week, you know, at home and just no show. It's quite weird, really, but we've got a big run coming up, of course. Yafai against Edwards this weekend, big show in Birmingham. Puerto Rico next weekend for Paro against Hitchens. Big Monaco show the week after, and then Saudi for Usyk Fury. So four big weeks to end another mad year. And today's been in Manchester, of course, the signing announcement of Pat Brown. And a massive crowd outside of people coming to, you know, witness the start of the journey, which is great. And, you know, this is just a small snippet of what you're seeing as one of the biggest ticket sellers in the country.
Well, obviously, you've had your week's rest now. We're on for a roll now. You've just signed Team GB Olympian Pat Brown on a long-term deal. How delighted are you to add him to the match?
Yeah, very much so. I mean, look, people always say, like, who should I look out for? Who's the next star of British boxing? And I look at someone like Pat Brown, they've got the pedigree through the Team GB, you know, Olympic system of winning big tournaments around the world. Obviously, he went to Paris as an Olympian for Team GB, but it's his fighting style. You know, he loves to fight. He loves to knock people out. He's got a massive fan base as well. I think he's the next big star, not just from Manchester, but from Britain as well. And I'm looking forward to the journey. It was a competitive race to sign him. We won that race, and now we've got to make the most of it and build him in the right way.
Well, obviously, Manchester's historic for boxing legends. Do you believe that Pat Brown will eventually end up?
I really do. I mean, you know, I think that we know with his ability, you look at the likes of like Chev Clark, another good example of an Olympian who's really won British and European titles or coming up without really breaking sweat. These guys should be performing at world level. And Pat is another guy. Give him time. Like, he's going to need his year of graduation and probably 6 to 8 fights. He's going to be in big domestic fights, and I believe he's a future world champion.
Well, speaking of Manchester boxers, you've promised Zelfa Barrett a big fight in Manchester. Could Pat potentially make his debut on the undercard of that?
Well, possibly. I mean, Zelfa's got a run-out fight coming up because obviously we're looking to land that big fight, but in the meantime, he needs to fight. I like the fight with Zelfa and Ray Ford as well. I think that's a really good fight. We're probably going to do something with Pat on his own in Manchester in March, just to like a next-gen style show to really give him that big launch. But, you know, Manchester's a vibrant fight scene. We had a great show recently with Catchall against Progre, doing big numbers. And you know, when Pat fights, you're going to see huge numbers in the city.
Well, speaking of next-gen, obviously, Huge Boxing have just announced that they've got a show coming up at York Hall. Obviously, a lot of next-gen fighters, such as Maisie Rose, George Ladd, Jimmy Sains. How proud are you to have that partnership with them?
Yeah, I mean, it's really important to us that fighters get activity. And, you know, when you look at the likes of Jimmy Sains, George Liddard, obviously Maisie's coming off a defeat, Shannon's coming off a defeat, you've got Paddy Donovan, you know, all these young fighters, they need activity. And sometimes we need those extra shows, whether it's Huge Boxing, you know, whether it's, you know, GBM, you know, whether it's Johnny Clark and Top Tier. It's really useful for us and useful for them as well to put talent on those shows to keep activity.
Well, obviously, as Pat Brown is a former Olympian, I've got to ask you about Ben Whitaker. He's gone quite quiet. Would you have advised him to do that?
I think going quiet's never really the answer, to be honest with you. I think sometimes you've got to come out and front it up when something like that happens. You know, in a lot of our stuff that's happened, whether it's Conor Ben, whether it's AJ, you know, you've got to come out and you've got to face the music, really. And, you know, for Ben, I think the quieter you are, sometimes that can go against you. But everyone's got their own style. I don't know what he's been advised, you know, but ultimately, you know, he's got to go out there and do his own thing. I'm sure he'll be back. He's a great fighter. It's going to be tough when he comes back. He's going to get a lot of stick, but, you know, I'm sure he'll be back.
Well, I spoke to Lyndon Arthur. He says he'd fight Ben Whitaker. Would that be a fight?
Good fight, yeah, look. You know, Ben, the fight back's going to be a tough one. I think he's got to fight Liam Cameron, you know.
That's scheduled for around March.
Yeah, but I think it's going to be a tough fight to come back to. You know, and obviously if he was to lose that fight, it'd be in a terrible situation. But Ben is a quality fighter, no doubt.
Well, in the last couple of weeks, we'll go on to Ben. In the last couple of weeks, it was announced that Conor Ben was cleared by the National Anti-Doping Panel. Nigel Benn has said that no one thought about Conor's mental health on the podcast with Simon Jordan. What did you make of his reaction to that?
Yeah, I don't think really anyone's really bothered about Conor Ben during this situation, which I think is a little bit, you know, emotionless and sometimes a little bit sad because he's a young man. And I know people are always quick to point the finger of guilt at people, but having been through all these processes and been cleared, do you actually consider now that the man is innocent, or even if you think he might be innocent, think about what he's had to go through during that time? But look, that's life, right? We can't necessarily feel sorry for everybody, because we've got to feel sorry for ourselves as well. You know, we all go through stuff. Sometimes you see it, sometimes you don't see it, and his was just very public, you know, and we've got to make sure that he gets back in the ring. Obviously, the nightmare is pretty much over now, and we've got a plan for what's next, whether that's Eubank, whether that's a world championship fight. Huge nights ahead for Conor Benn.
I don't know how much of the interview you watched, but what was your reaction to the bits you did watch with the Simon Jordan interview?
I don't really watch too much of it, to be honest with you. I mean, look, Simon's very good at what he does, which is like to create talking points, to create controversy. You know, is it agenda-led? Sometimes I think it is. He might argue it isn't, but you know, it's his job to drive viewership and to drive conversation. He's very good at that. I don't think he knows a huge amount about boxing. Does he need to? Don't matter. You know, it's still an entertaining show.
Do you think that Conor Benn can ever kind of repair his reputation, or do you think people will kind of always bring that up whenever he fights and look at him as...
Yeah, maybe, but it's just life, isn't it? You know, it's just... Maybe it never leaves.
Well, it looks like AJ's rematch with Dubois is not happening now. Was that more of a business or boxing decision?
No, I mean, he may well rematch Dubois next. He just won't do it on February 22nd. You know, he won't be ready for that date. He won't be physically ready. And when you go into a fight as dangerous as that, you've got to be 100% ready. And if he's not, you can't do it. And it was a tough decision to turn it down. But the rematch is going to be there, whether it's May, June. And of course, it gives us the opportunity to look at the Tyson Fury fight on December 21st and see what happens.
How much will he be rooting Tyson Fury to win, to get the match?
Always. He's a Brit. You know, I want Tyson Fury to win. I love Usyk, but I wanted Fury to win the first fight and hopefully wins the second fight. But, you know, win or lose, that's a massive fight with Anthony Joshua. But again, we'll see what happens December 21st.
And finally, Dubois Parker, February 22nd, who wins?
It's a good fight, you know. I think Joseph's in great form. You know, I think he's beaten Wilder, he's beaten Zhang. He's a tenacious heavyweight. Daniel's on a great run of form. If that fight gets made, it's a great fight.
Oh, sorry, one more, because I am seeing you later this week. We've got Sonny Edwards,
yes,
and Galali Fai in Birmingham. Cannot wait for that.
Yeah.
Undercard's great as well.
Yeah, it's a really good show. Really good show. Top to bottom action, and a great all-British fight between two great rivals, you know, individuals and families as well. Two great young men. Exactly what we want to see. Big fights of British boxing. Huge show this Saturday in Birmingham.
How do you see it going?
It's a pure 50-50 fight. Is it too early for Galau? Is Galau too good for Sonny? I mean, who knows? But we'll find out this Saturday.
Well, catch up with you later.